Good Tuesday to you. As we walk through Easter week, Holy Week is the week prior to the crucifixion, Good Friday, and the Resurrection Sunday. The following week is called Easter week. It's the time when Christians usually take this time to reflect, to rededicate, and to find a new vision of hope and ministry that God is calling them to, perhaps they've never considered before. As we look at what is new in our lives, I'd like for us to reflect on something very important. In Mark's Gospel, the 15th chapter, we have some very interesting events. In 36, it says, and whenever he was talking, he said, Jesus on the cross, he said, Elio, Elio, lama sabachthani. He says, my God, why have you forsaken me? And some of the bystanders thinking that he was calling upon Elijah. And Elijah was the only person outside of Enoch that never died, that they translated right into the presence of God. And so the people who were sat there gawking and halfway listening thought that he was calling upon Elijah, but he wasn't. He was praying, this prayer coming from Psalms. And they said, listen, let's see if Elijah comes and rescues him. And someone ran and filled a sponge with sour wine, put it on a stick, and gave it for him to drink, saying, wait, let us see whether Elijah comes to take him away and take him down. And then verse 37, Jesus gave a loud cry and breathed his last. And the curtain of the temple, which is anywhere from 5 to 6 inches thick, that was ornately woven with wool and flax and also had crispness with regard to inner jewels that was bespeckled. And folks, no human hand could tear that apart. It says, and it was rent, it was broken, torn from top to bottom. And the fact of the matter is, that when this is so mentioned in this gospel account, it means that the temple worship is no longer needed. The new covenant that Jesus has given in ushering in the new kingdom, the kingdom of God, requires a new way of looking at God and a new manner of serving God. God no longer wants 10% of our tithes and offerings. He wants all of you. He wants all of me. Now, you're saying, oh my goodness, that means he wants all of my money, all of my possessions? Yes, but let me tell you how he does it. He doesn't ask you to give all of it. All he wants is you. He wants your devotion, your praise, your trust, and your willingness to give back to him everything you possess. For you see, he already owns it anyway, and he's wanting to see, are you willing to give everything back to him that he's given to you? We think we're self-made people. We're not. We're made because God has given us the talent to be who we are. God has created us in his image, and he wants to see and know, are you willing to give your heart and your life to him? Because see, if he has our heart, our lives, he has everything we own. So if he asks you to do something with it, he doesn't have to worry whether it'll be done. You will do it, share it, and use it as his resources forever. So when God the Father, it was Jesus who gave his life, but it was God the Father who tore the veil in the temple of Holy and Holies in two. Let's pray. Father, we're here on Easter Tuesday, and we've just had the most exciting time in our lives as we have connected with your love through the crucifixion and the resurrection. And now, Father, we're walking toward the ascension where you fulfilled your kingdom by sitting at the right hand of the Father, and you hear our prayers even now. Hear us, Father. We offer all that we are to you. Amen. God bless you. Make this a wonderful Tuesday for Jesus Christ. It is his day, a gift he's given to you and to me. Let's use it to honor him. I'll see you tomorrow morning. God bless you.